Hello everyone, I'm Dragonwhip and welcome back to Stranded Deep. It just seems like I cannot put this game down. This game is so good to play. I love playing this game. Besides that fact, there's a few things about the raft that I needed to touch base on that I wanted to let everybody know. Where did that stick go? There it is. But basically, when I built the raft originally, I did not know which way was forward, which was backward, which way was sideways, which way was up and down. But I figured that, like I said, I figured it out. So now it's just a matter of getting all the resources together. There's some more potatoes that I don't want to mess with right now because, hey, free potatoes. But basically what I'm doing now is I'm just grabbing as many sticks as I can, because these trees that I'm getting the sticks from actually respawn. So, that was kind of cool. They stood on top of each other. But yeah, those trees respawn, whereas the ones that I cut down when I first came to this island, yeah, they no longer exist. Not even the stumps are around anymore. So, yeah, we just have to keep our eye out for not tearing down any trees, but just do a bunch of sticks if we need to. As you can see, I went exploring just a little bit with that Mr. Raft. Super fast, dude. Oh my goodness, it's so fast. We got all this plank scrap that we can use for a base now, which is fantastic. All we need to do now is basically just set this thing up properly. So what I'm going to do is, I think I have enough fiber sleeves. I do. So let's go to the loom. Let's craft another piece of cloth. And I need two more fiber sleeves. I think I have a chest. There we go. Got enough fiber sleeves now, so I'm actually going to make some lashing. Is one of the ingredients. I'm actually going to put the fiber sleeves in this chest, along with some water. I pretty much made myself a first aid kit of sorts. I need to take these leaves out, but I've filled all these coconuts up with... That coconut is not full. It said it was empty. Excuse me. So it should be full now. So let's put this away. I don't know. It says it's empty, but I don't know. Anyway, let's grab this lashing. And we're going to have to make sure we have the sticks, which I got tons of, just from scrounging from around our island with the renewable stuff. And as you can see from our raft, this way where the sail is pointing, let's hop on this. We're not going to go anywhere. But as you can see, that's pointing that way, and this is pointing this way. That's the front. Well, this one's the front. That's technically the back. And if you decide later that that's not the way it is the way we have it built so far is the fact that, these are all side by side. And I want our raft to be opposite way. I actually want I want the direction to be when we move, like this is forward, this was backward, etc. So basically what we're going to do is we climb onto our raft. And we're going to take our axe and we're just going to dismantle this. Yes, I know. We spend all the resources gathering it, but I don't like the way the raft moves because we've built it kind of wrong. I should have put this all in the front, but it's okay since it's too wide. And yeah, anyway, basically what we're going to do now is we're going to go to our crafting menu, go back to rafts, propulsion. We should have enough. We need the hammer. Okay. That's one thing I did forget. So let's just drop the stick here for now. Let's go grab our hammer, which I have put in here with our 22 durability. Here we go. Awesome. So now we should be able to make the propulsion. And as you can see, when I hold this up here, the little stick that's pointing toward me, that means that it's going to be facing the same way as we had it before. But if you come off to the side here, as you can see now, it's facing behind us or towards us, which means it's going to be in the proper direction. I know that's hard, probably a little bit hard to explain, but the way that the raft was before is the sail was sitting like this. What I want it to do is I want it to sit like that. There's two different directions. So that way, when we build this, we can get on this. And this now, let's actually take a little test drive out of it. Let's, come on, Mr. Raft. Let's go. See, now, this is front, that's back. And because I've changed it up in the way it's built and the propulsion, it's a lot easier to turn. As you can see, I'm turning with super, super speed now. Whereas before, it was too wide, and it wound up going to not performing correctly. Oop, let's go backwards and turn. Oop, come on, turn for me. There we go. It takes a little bit of time to turn. I mean, it's not a perfect system, and I don't expect it to be. So, but now I've gotten the raft exactly the way I want it. No big deal. Jump and pull it back to the shore. But that's one thing I wanted to touch base on with the raft. That's why we couldn't turn very easily, and that's why we had to carry that tire in reverse. I think now that we've actually got a big front end, we probably could go get our raft now. But today we're basically going to be working on getting something that's very, very special that we need. Not more or less want, but it's a more of a desperate need, at least to me anyway. It's pretty much what I'm going to build today is called a smoker. And the smoker basically will prolong the life of any food that you put in the smoker. As you can see here, we have our spit, which is basically, you know, over a campfire that, you know, we just cook food straight up on our spit. We can upgrade this to a hobo stove later. We can, like, tear down this spit and put a hobo stove on top of it. So basically now I'm just having to find an area, which I probably will put our smoker over here on the beach. That sounds like a good idea. So we have to completely build another campfire, which is no big deal. I mean, yeah, it only takes a few sticks. And I'm actually going to put this right here. And now we can make a fire pit. I think we have to make it a fire pit. Let's check this thing for the smoker. Yes, it requires a fire pit. So let's grab some rocks. Or actually, we can leave the rocks on the ground. And we just need to craft the fire pit and put it around our campfire. Awesome. Now, the next thing we need is 3 sticks and some lashings. That seems simple enough, you think, with the little picture down here. It would require a tarp, but I'm not going to question it. So let's check in our little box. Let's make us a lashing. Go to back to tools. Lashing, there we go. Now back to structures. Make a smoker. I want the smoker. Is there only one direction? Can you not? Oh, maybe we can use the Q and E to rotate. Yes, awesome. I want it to be facing this way. Close enough. Fantastic. Now we have ourselves a smoker. So any meats that we decide we want to do is like we want to catch a seagull or catch us a bat during the night, or even as far as, let's grab our little, let's put some of this stuff down. Let's take these sticks and put them on our stick pile. Oh wow, I used the sticks that were on our stick pile. No problem. Let's put those sticks down there. Let's grab this stick over here that we put down on the... Did I use that one too? Apparently I did. Okay. No big deal. So how the smoker works is you go around and I'm just going to grab... Ooh, hello. Let's see if we can catch that bird. And... Hoo-yah! I missed. Hoo-yah! Oh, I missed again. Oh, and I broke one of my spears. Oh, well. Too bad. Too bad. I'm not very good at aiming the spears just yet, so... We could get us a... Oh, I'm running really low on spears. We got to go get some more. Apparently the other one that I threw is disappeared. Probably. Come on. Oh, I missed. Oh, I got him. I got him. Yeah, I got the seagull. Nice. So we have the seagull now. Let's switch back. Let's see if we can go find us a crab. And I'm just going to try to get as much meat as I can. Whoa, hello. I haven't really searched the island today other than what you saw me do. So, oh, look, piece of corrugated scrap. We'll have to. Well, hello, Mr. Crab. Let's grab that guy. Come on, I need one, at least a couple more. I don't want to start the fire just for... I mean, it does take a little while for the smoker to kick in. So what we could do... is we come down here and use our little... our thing to catch some fish. And catching fish is a lot harder than it seems. Come on, Mr. Fish. You actually have to... yeah, there we go. You actually have to get on it. Like, focus on the fish. It doesn't... There we go. Oh, gotta remember to breathe. Is there anything down here? Some more fish. Oh, come on. Gotcha. And, I mean, yeah, it's only sardines and cards. Pickards, however you pronounce it. I mean, but that's better than nothing. Ooh. There's two and one right there. Come on, let me grab you. I mean, I'm pretty sure that I could probably throw this at the... oh, hello, Mr. Seagull. The seagull flew away. Let's see if I could throw my spear at it. Oh, he took off. Never mind. Anyway, I think we have enough. I honestly think we have enough. So here we go. Drop the crabs. Let's just put our hunting spear back up. Fishing spear. Yeah, let's put it there for a second. And we've got to drop the food on the ground because naturally we're going to have to skin all of this. And throwing all the fish on the ground. Whoop, hey, you, mister, get back over here. You need to be with the rest. All right, our durability on our knife is pretty good. So let's skin the seagull. And there we go.
Oh, gross.
Oh, gross. Well, it's going to keep you alive, man.
Oh, gross.
And yes, we're going to have to do this for each individual fish, crabs. Oh, I mean, granted, gross. It is just small meat, but... small meat can go a long way, especially if it's well preserved. So that's what basically the smoker's there for, is to preserve meat to last a long while. So that way you can carry...
oh, it's disgusting.
Like basically the little box we have behind us that has the four coconuts filled with water, I could just pick that up and then if we put some of the smoked meat once it's smoked... in that box, we'll have both food and water, so if we decide we don't want to have to come back home immediately when we're hungry or anything, we could stay out probably a couple of days, as long as our sleeping meter decides it's going to stay up. Oh, missed a fish. Alright, mister. So we got a bunch of meat to process. And the cool thing about this, though, is as long as the meat will fit in this smoker, it will smoke it. So let's throw this in here. Make sure it's laying down flat. I don't think it matters if it is laying down flat or not, but I'm going to try to make it look as nice and neat and professional as possible because that's just how I roll. Come on. Well, you want to stick like that? Just lay down. There we go. And then once we get this, get all these pieces of meat in here, this is going to be a nice feast for whenever we need it. And unlike cooking it on the campfire just straight up, this is going to last us a long while, if I haven't already said that. I think I may have. But all this meat will get smoked. And I'm just going to set it and forget it, because as long as this meat's in here, it'll get smoked. I'm just hoping that I'll have to watch it. After so long, I'll probably have to watch this to see exactly, once this campfire runs out, I'll have to watch to see how fast or how long it takes to get all this smoked. So let's go over here and grab our kindling. And let's turn this fire on. There we go. And the smoker is smoking. Now, with that being said, it's going to take a while. It usually takes a long, long time to get this smoker. From what the testing I have done, it takes a long time for this smoker to work. There is no other smoker on the island. It's more or less I didn't save when I built myself one of these. So we just got to make sure all the meat is in here. And I knocked a piece out. That's not good. There we go. Let's grab this meat. Put it in here. There we go. So I'm just going to set it and try to calculate the time. It is 17:32 roughly. So I think this takes about 5-10 minutes real life. Not in game, because of course, you know, the time passes faster. So while that's working, I think I'm going to take the newly formed raft. Make sure we need to get some water. Not very much needed, but I like to keep my stats pretty high. We're waiting for food, but you know what we probably could do is just cook at least one piece of this for now. I mean, you can use the smoker as a regular campfire. As you can see, I'm just holding the meat here. It could be used for a lot of things other than, you know, it could be used for meat storage, whatever have you. But the smoker is a nice addition to have, especially since we are in need of food when we go off long distance and we don't want to really get our food spoiled, eat our food spoiled, because it does make us sick. That's basically what has happened to me over the course of the last few episodes, is I've eaten spoiled coconut, which, yeah, coconut can spoil. And that's what causes you your hunger to go down super, super fast. And it's not very delicious to do that, because you think you're filling up your hunger, but when you do, you eat spoiled food, it drops it by 75. So you wind up having to cook and find fresh food. And if you don't have any around, you could die. So that's, yeah. Hopefully this meat cooks pretty fast so we can get on our way. Alright, it's cooked, and none of this is smoked yet, and it's only been about 2 hours in-game, which is not too bad. But I've noticed that a lot of my tools, the durability is going down. Oh, hello. Okay, apparently that didn't take that long. It didn't. Wow, that only took about 2 hours in-game to smoke. That's... Oh man, now I can't put the fire out. I don't even have a bucket. Oh, that's upsetting. And I'm just going to leave the other smoke pieces here. And I'm going to go over here and take the fiber sleeves out. But I am going to put our cooked meat in there, because that cooked meat will last a long, long time. Actually, you know what? Take the hammer out. Let's go ahead and put another 2, 3, 4. We put another thing up. another fork of smoked meat in there. Probably better just to put it down on the ground, but I like to have a crate. Especially since we... where's that label maker? I remember bringing it up here. What happened to that label maker? And I leave it on the island. Bollocks. We'll have to go find it. So let's make sure we don't have anything in our inventory that we could... Let's check this wooden crates. What happened to all my wooden crates? That's what I want to know. I don't remember what I did with them. Ah, here they are. These are my empty ones. So I want to make sure I put my hammer in here. And probably could put other tools in here as well, like my fibrous leaves. So that way we can carry it around with us just in case we find boat parts. Or raft parts, and we can go around then and make sure that we incorporate the raft in what we need. I have a good design that I'm going to do for this raft. It requires a bunch of sticks, though. That's the only problem. I could start building on that, but I think we could find other things. Like the buoy balls, we need one more. We have four here. We just need one more, and I don't know where to get them. And I guess that's just random finds. So let's fill the rest of our inventory up with the extra empties that we have. And we have space for one more, which is good. Because once we put it in our hand, or take our torch out of our hand, it's basically gonna do. But basically today, what I want to do now that we've got the smoker up and running, I want to go find a bucket, because I hear that we can save on the campfire if we had a bucket. So, all right, we're going to have to drag this thing off. I beached it really good. That's our parking spot. Let's get our compass. Let's look at it through the moon. I want to go. We have been going. Oh, I can't see. I've left so much stuff behind, it's ridiculous. But we need to go get that stuff. So, oh, I can't see. Well, I guess I could look the opposite direction. So we kept going that way. So that was to the west. Hello, bats. So I want to go back over there. Hopefully, oh wait, no, not the west. We left our tires over there. So that's where all the other stuff is. So let's actually head back over to that direction where we supposedly had our tires. And hopefully that all that those crates and stuff are still over there. So that way we can pick up the torches and lanterns and everything that we had to leave behind due to inventory lack of space. Another thing that we could probably look for, like I said, I'm wanting to find a bucket for sure. Because, like I was mentioning earlier, if you have a bucket full of water, you can dump it on the fire and it'll put the fire out. I don't know if that's a mod or if that's intended to get in the game, but I want to try to test it out, needless to say, because if we can save our wood from burning all the time, that's a good thing, because that way you save on resources and save sticks. And even though those things are renewable, it's better not to waste. If you can keep from wasting, then it's best to not waste. As you can see with this sail, we are super, super quick. We're hauling across the sea now. We can turn relatively quickly, like I showed earlier. Let's actually stop for a second. Let's get our flashlight, turn this on. So that way we can actually see what's going on. We can make sure our raft is going in the straightest most area. So is this where we found? I think this is where our tires were. Yeah, I think this is where we had our beached our tires before. I think we went over in that direction, and that's why we got lost. But things respawn, so it probably wouldn't hurt to come back over here and see if anything has respawned. Hello, bats. Hello, Mr. Island. Yep, there's our tree we downed. So let's check this boat again. There's a possibility that stuff in it has respawned. Let's go down. Nothing in there. Nothing in there. I'm pretty sure the snakes are back by now, because we haven't been to this island. I think it was last episode. But still, every time you close the game and reopen the game, things have a tendency to respawn for you. Hello, Mr. Piggy. Yeah, that's another thing we're going to have to get into. I don't want to have to do it, but those pigs give medium meat, and then you can farm them twice, as far as I know. So we probably need to start getting into the medium meat and start killing piggies, because, I mean, fish can last a while, but if we can get better, bigger and better food, it probably will be more sufficient for us. Let's check down here. See if there's anything in here. Nope. All right, get back to the surface, please. Yeah, I know. Ooh, some more plank scrap. Probably need to grab that. Yeah, let's grab that. Where did this tree come from? I don't know why that tree has fallen. Oh well. Nothing on this island, so let's hop back on Mr. Raft. I'm gonna call him Rafty for now. I still haven't gotten any name suggestions for this, so I'm just gonna call him Mr. Rafty. Because that's what he is a raft. He's doing very good by us. Alright, let's just back up and go forward. So that's home. Let's go over here to this island. Hopefully we can find some shipwrecks between here and there. And yeah, I know it's probably bad recording during the night time, but the moon is very bright. Only time I think it would be an issue is when the moon is, you know, in the new moon type situation. Or full moon. No, full moon we could see. I think that's what we're doing now. And our new moon is just, it's completely dark. But at least we got our flashlight. Well, if we can find our little lantern that we found when we were making our raft, we can find that. I can put it on the raft here, leave it on. So that way we can have like a little beacon. That'd be kind of cool, wouldn't you think? I hear the sharks, or the music that plays when the sharks are around. Look at all these fish around here. Holy crap. That's a lot of fish. I mean, worst case scenario, if we ever run out of food, we can always go fishing. Kind of like what we did today. Just always go fishing. There's plenty of fish. And as long as you have at least one water still, a couple would be nice, but as long as you have one water still, I don't think you'll run out of water. Next thing we need to work is getting a distiller, but that's one of the reasons why I'm looking for a bucket. There's Mr. Inner Tube over there. So yeah, this is the island that we left all our stuff on because we couldn't pick it up. That's another thing I need to work on. Oh, so much stuff to work on. Yeah, let's pick this. Let's put our scrap in there. Pick this up. There's our label maker. Okay. Let's see. Let's put... Let's drop this. That's that. Let's drop this one. Alright, let's put our skinning knife in there. So that way we can pick up all of the things. Oh man. Oh, my hands are full, so I'm gonna have to. Man, if I could have pulled out my spear at that point, I think we'd be having some bat. Oh hey. Just drop that. Oh, he moved. You know what? Let's see if I can find that box really fast. Not that one. Nope, not that one. Nope, not that one either. There we go. Let's trade this. I know I said I didn't like the lantern because you can't really focus the beam. But, yeah. We can actually see on the ground a lot better. So I'm actually going to put this on the rest. There we go. And as you can see, it stays on and it's solar powered. So, and you can leave it, you can turn it on and off by holding, pressing and holding E. So that's nice. Can I don't have room. Ugh, fine. So let's set sail. As you can see, our little lantern is staying on the boat. Whoa, wait. There's two boats here? Can we search? Can we search this one? Hey, look at that. All right. Let's see if we can manipulate this to... Oh, nope. Good thing I caught it. All right, let's put this... Uh-oh. Nope. Nope. Come on. I'm trying to center it on the raft. There we go. Hey, Mr. Tiger Shark, leave me alone, please. Oh, I moved myself. Where am I? Okay. There's a box right there. Come on, let's get a little bit closer. A little bit closer. And let's move this box. There we go, that should work. Now, these sharks are here. And I've learned a little trick. If you're quick, they don't bother you. So, ahoy! Ow. Okay, apparently I was wrong. He attacked me like immediately as I jumped off, so they must have updated the game. Alright, are you gone now? Where'd you go? Actually, I want to see what was in that crate. Let's bring it to the shore so that way there's no chance of being bitten. That's just had a torch in it. That's the one we just had, that we just found. And I'm just gonna, that's really bad. There's our survival kit. That's empty. That one's another thing. Oh, that one's empty. Okay. So once we get, now that we've gotten the label maker, let's grab that. Let's equip it. And basically what I want to do is I think this is the right one. Yes. This is going to be our survival kit. We'll have another one that's going to be labeled first aid for bandages and morphine and vitamins or whatever. But I think the way to use this is you left click on it and name it what you want. And this one's going to be food. And see now, the box is not labeled wood crate, it's labeled food. And I even think, yes, in your inventory, as you hover over the things, you can find out exactly what crate you are looking for. For instance, that one's labeled food, where these are labeled wood crate. And I think one of these has a bandage in it. No, I don't need that one. Wood crate. Where did that one go? Is it the one in my hand? No, the one in my hand's food. It might be the one that's on the boat. All right. So let's pick all these crates back up. Oh, that's right. I need to put the label maker up. There we go. So that's a little nifty little trick if you ever run across a label maker. So let's hurry up and get back onto the boat. Come on. There we go. Well, that one has just scrap of whatever. I don't know where this thing went. But still, I wanna... Oh man, Mr. Shark, leave me alone. You already bit me once today. Leave me alone. see if we can go get these, this metal, this scrap. Hey! Can I? No, I can't pick it up from this angle. But we could just do like, look this. Nope, doesn't work. There we go. Tangling with the sharks, always fun. I don't think I've actually explored this one too much. So as long as we go away. Eventually, one of these days, I'm going to kill you. And then you're going to be like, I wish I went away. I wish I went away. Oh, he's such a big thing. He thinks he's a little hotshot. Oh, well, let's jump in. See if we can get that. Oh, hello, lionfish. No. Yeah, lionfish, don't tangle with a lionfish. Lionfish are bad. I think they're just as bad as sharks if you get stung by one. Alright, so apparently we've finished that place up. Well, excuse me, sir. Let's go over here and see if we can't consolidate some inventory and try to make room for that little Mr. Raft over here so we can bring him back home. Oh, we left a torch. Come on, Mr. Lantern. Get back on here. Wow, that thing's heavy. There we go. And we don't have enough inventory. Uh-oh. So let's put our compass and that one's empty. Can we put another crate on the raft? Is this one? Yeah, that one's got food in it. I think we can still move. Yeah, we're able to still move. Awesome. I need to check my needs. We need a little food, we need a little water, but we're about to head home anyway. So let's get over here near our inflatable raft, so that way if we ever lose this raft, we have one for backup rather than having to swim across the ocean and run the risk of getting entangled with a shark. All right, this should be good. Come on. Oh, hello. I don't know why I thought this raft took an inventory spot. Put that in there. And I need to pick up my food chase. My food crate. Alright, let's see if we can't. Yeah, let's grab that. If we can see when that falls off. Okay. Are we good? I might need to. Yeah, that's what I thought. Oh no. Come here, Mr. Crate. You need to go right there. Mr. Raft, come on. Gotta make sure that when you do carry stuff on the raft that it's very centered and weight balanced. Alright, this should work. Mr. Shark knocking at our door. I mean, if we have to go backwards, that's fine too. I don't mind going backwards. The controls are inverted, but that's okay. I can't turn very well, but we're moving. Oh wow, the waves are big. Can we go forward? Not really. Oh no! I think we lost our crate. Uh-oh. Another thing I could probably do, since it looks like they interact very well. Now get up here, please. So I probably could push it. See if I can push it. I did lose a crate to the bottom of the ocean, so... And I don't think it had very... that much stuff in it, so... Come on, turn. There we go. Get square up. I didn't square it up very right. But. Come on. Oh. Yeah, it's not working too well. Let's see if I can get squared up. There we go. I can turn really, really slowly. And we gotta go back over that direction. It may take me a little while, but at least we're not, you know, off kilter. But I think that'll be do it for today. That's a good enough place to stop. So I hope everybody had fun today while I learned a lot of stuff about the raft and, like, especially with the way I have this thing set up. And I hope everybody learned something as well, because, you know, it's all about the massive learning experience. But thank everybody for watching. We're getting little rafty home. So, yeah. Thank everybody for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a big thumbs up. And until next time, see you later.